wo ich doch schon mit dir geredet habe. Du hast ja gesehen, wie vernünftig wir miteinander reden.
Ja, vernünftig seine
ja,
Sache.
Alter, jetzt auf einmal sagst du mir wieder so,
nee,
aber
aber du
morgen wieder was
blamierst doch.
anderes.
Ich habe eine Frage an dich. Du blamierst doch meinen Glauben. Also blamierst du mich auch. Mein
Du,
Glaube
du hast
zählt
doch gesagt,
für mich.
du hast
Und
doch selber
fertig
ein
aus.
Problem mit dem Islam.
Nee, habe ich nicht. Du hast
Doch,
eine Frage
jetzt hast
gestellt
du
und gesagt,
gesagt, dass du ein Problem mit dem Islam
nee,
hast.
ich habe ein Problem mit der Sache, was du mir vorgesagt hast, was in unseren
Du glaubst doch selber
damaligen
nicht, dass der
Podcast ist.
Koran vollständig ist, hast du gesagt.
Das haben wir an dem Tag so geredet, aber ich habe nicht gesagt, dass er nicht
Ja,
vollständig ist. Ich
danke.
habe gesagt, in
Siehst
Gottes
du,
Augen,
also hast du ein Problem mit dem Islam, siehst du?
da sagst du mir.
Du hast das doch gesagt, Mann. Oh.
Ja, das ist eine Ansichtssache.
Und
Aber
bitte,
guck mal,
bitte. Ich
ich
habe
habe eine
keine Lust
Frage.
auf diese komischen
Eine Frage
Gespräche.
an dich.
Möchtest du mit mir
Hier,
über was
warum
anderes
redest du mit
reden
dem
oder
Joker? Warum redest du
möchtest du
nicht
mit mir
mit
über die
ihm?
Bestandteile des Islams reden oder was machen wir?
Ich habe eine Frage, eine letzte Frage noch.
He's here to waste your time, right?
Ich frage nur,
Yes, he's here to
wieso
waste my
redest du
time.
nicht mit diesem Joker? Der weiß doch über Islam viel. Wieso redest du nicht mit ihm?
Boah, das ist doch jemand, der Fingernägel und Fußnägel lackiert. Was, seit wann hat der denn Ahnung von irgendetwas, Mann? Das kann doch nicht wahr sein, Mann. Ich kann nicht mehr, das kann doch nicht mehr wahr sein. Brother, here in Germany it is. It's in America it is too. I believe so, yes. The ignorance is amazing. The ignorance is amazing. Brother, are you talking or I didn't hear, I did
yeah,
not hear you.
Sorry, I forgot that I was muted. Some people are asking in the chat why I wear this bracelet. This is thread, it's nothing special. But we Orthodox Christians, I'm Orthodox Christian. We Orthodox Christians, we wear this before Easter. And it resembles the red color, it's small, tiny thread. The red color resembles the blood of Christ and the white is the body of Christ. So it's pure tradition, church tradition. Nothing more, nothing less. It has nothing to do with Yazidi. Come on, guys, we're Christians.
Yazidi.
Yazidi.
I don't know what they all have with Yazidi. They hate him to death.
Yeah. Yazidis are kuffara. They are pagans. They, according to the Muslims, they are...
According to the Muslims, yeah. They hate them to death. They kill them wherever they find them.
Yes. Yes. So how's life in Germany, brother? How are the...
Life in Germany is very, very expensive.
Expensive.
Very expensive.
You have a lot of Catholics, Orthodox people in Germany. I speak a lot of, to a lot of German people. I have German friends, so this is why I know a little bit German. Ich spreche ein bisschen Deutsch, ja?
Great! Ein bisschen Deutsch, sehr gut.
Ich liebe dich.
Rob Christian,
wir lieben dich auch, Rob. Wir lieben dich alle, Rob, hier in Deutschland. Also, like, every Orthodox, every Christian here in Germany loves you, really. Our whole community loves you.
Yeah, ich auch.
Rob Christian, brother, I have a question for you because I know a sheikh who is like making TikTok debates and something like that. He asked me if you want to debate him because he was the one who told me that Al-Waqidi was a Shia and he was a kafir and he was lying about the prophet, you know?
Yeah, but well, why if he's a kafir and he's a fabricator, why are they using, why these hypocrite Sunnis, why are they using a fabricated hadith of Al-Waqidi to defend their mother Aisha?
Yes.
That's the point.
Dann ist auf einmal Al-Waqidi wieder sehr gut, ne, wenn es darum geht, Aisha zu verteidigen.
Der Hamdi, das ist der Hamdi. Der Hamdi meinte so zu mir, Al-Waqidi ist ein Schia, der Al-Waqidi lügt. Dann hat er jetzt gerade eben den Hadith gebracht, dass, er mit der, dass das in einem Gefäß gebracht wird, ne, Amir, dass das von Al-Waqidi kommt. Das ist unfassbar.
Siehst du?
But they use
siehst du, was kein Heuchler
ist? Even worse, brother. Look, Ibn Hajar used Al-Waqidi. Ibn Hajar Al-Asqalani, the giant Hafiz Sunni scholar, he made this hadith in Sa'd, Ibn Sa'd Tabaqat Al-Kubra, volume 8, page 271, about the milk in the cup. He made it famous. But he didn't tell people that Al-Waqidi is a liar, a fabricator. Even the classical scholars are a bunch of liars and deceivers.
Can you maybe zoom down so I can screenshot this for my colleague? Thanks. Thanks, brother. I'll show it.
Let me give you the full link. Here's the full chain of the narration for the hadith.
Thanks, brother, because I'll collect something like that so that I can debate with him the next time about this. You know?
Yes, brother, yes, no problem. Please use our material, guys, because you never know when the Lord decides to take us home. You know, brother Amir here, he's a dear brother here. I love to talk to him, and he's an awesome, awesome. To be honest with you, it's not easy to be an ex-Muslim and show your face. You know,
also ex-Muslim. So I come from a diocese.
The moment you expose Islam, brothers and sisters, your life is at risk. We know the consequences when we talk about Islam. But, you know, we are not better than Stephen, who was stoned outside the walls of Jerusalem. We are not better than the church fathers and apostles who died for the name of Christ. So, you know, if it's our time to go back to the Lord, then so be it. We're not scared. We're here. And brother, if any sheikh, if he thinks he is a backbone, he is man enough. He's more man than his mother Aisha. We're always here. Let him come and debate me. Yalla. Let's debate.
All right. Then, Rob Christian, you would accept the debate with Hamdi?
Any sheikh. Welcome.
I'll kiss your heart, brother.
He's nothing. He's just the kleine flieg, he's the fly.
Brother, I will make him.
He doesn't have a title. He's nothing. He's nothing here in Germany. Nothing.
Amir, tell them, translate. My name won't be Rob Christian. My name won't be Rob Christian if this sheikh comes and debate me, and I will force him to do the monkey dance in front of all of you. My name won't be Rob Christian. What I will do to him.
Der würde nicht mehr Rob Christian heißen, wenn er in der Debatte nicht quasi ihm den Affentanz machen lassen würde, the Monkey Dance.
Watch what I will do to the Sheikh. Guys, I'm sitting literally, I joined TikTok recently. I'm new to TikTok. Until now, I challenge so many Muslim channels. I want to debate your imams. I'm now for almost 7 months, I think, on TikTok. I'm new. I'm still a baby to TikTok. But not one dares to debate me once they see my name. Why? I'm waiting. Come.
You know why, Rob? Because you can speak Arabic. It's always there. Yeah. They always say you can't translate Arabic. It's just a metaphor. It's just,
Das ist dein Vorteil. Das ist dein Vorteil, dass er Arabisch sprechen und lesen kann.
Ja, weil so können sie ihm nicht vorwerfen, dass es aus dem Kontext gerissen
ist. Deswegen haben die auch etwas mehr Angst vor ihm als so vor anderen, die nur so Deutsch oder Englisch verstehen, weißt du? Aber das reicht auch eigentlich schon aus, wenn du Deutsch und Englisch verstehst, das ist eigentlich schon sehr gut. Aber Arabisch nochmal zu können, ist für diese Religion ja das A und O, ne? Wahnsinn.
Yeah.
We need men like Rob.
Well, I hope people will use my material, you know, my videos are, you know, basically, Amir, maybe you can translate. We created videos on YouTube, and I hope people watch our videos and use our material. Don't allow our material to go in vain. Use what we are showing from the books. Copy them, use them, create small video clips, and translate them. People need to learn about the true face of Islam, not the lying, false deception that they call the Islam here in the West. Translate, brother.
Yes, also er hat einen YouTube-Kanal, in dem er genau denselben Namen trägt, wie er da jetzt oben steht, Rob Christian. Und er sagt, wir sollen das Material nutzen in unseren Gesprächen, überall verbreiten, übersetzen, so dass man das quasi mit allen teilt, ne? Dass man nicht so unwissend bleibt. Ne?
Rob
das ist sehr, sehr gut. Sehr, sehr gut, was er macht. Er gibt sich da sehr viel Mühe, geht in die Quellen rein. Und ihr seht ja auch in meinem letztes Video auf YouTube habe ich ja auch von ihm benutzt, wo keiner auf einmal den Gedanken kam, das irgendwie in Frage zu stellen. Versteht ihr? Weil ich ganz genau weiß, dass sich das da drin halt befindet und er zeigt uns das. Ne? Das ist das Geniale daran. Benutzt das Material, teilt es mit euren Leuten und lernt davon.
Rob, would it be okay for you when I translate the videos in German and call the channel like Rob Christian in German or something like that?
Sure, my videos are yours. My videos are for free, everybody. But please, guys, keep them for free. They are for free. Keep them for free.
Ja, das Gute ist, dass er auch so Short-Videos hat, also so Kurzvideos, so 2-3 Minuten, die kann man ja schnell übersetzen, ne?
Ja, ja. Und das ist auch super TikTok-freundlich, weißt du, weil das sind so Swipe-Up-Videos, die man sich halt gut angucken kann. Das funktioniert.
Ja.
And so, yeah, this, you know, guys, we really need to help. And I thought, again, guys, yes, we can be really harsh with Muslims sometimes. We have to be sometimes aggressive. But again, we do not hate any Muslim. We are doing this to show them the real Islam, not the fake Islam that their shuyukh are teach them.
Yes. It's the truth, because Rob, I was a Daeshi myself, and yeah, I supported like terrorist
groups. Oh, you're an ex-Muslim too, brother?
Yeah, yeah, I'm an ex-Muslim too, and one of the worst ex-Muslims that you maybe know in your life. I hated the Orthodox Church in Syria. I hated the Assyrian guys. I hated the Aramaic guys. Like, they was always my enemies. As a Turk, I hated them. Like, the Armenians, everyone who wasn't a Muslim and coming from our countries, I hated them. Just basically off being a Christian, that was so different.
Yeah. Well, God bless you, brother. It's never too late to see the mistakes of Islam, the filth of Islam. And nobody else can save you but Jesus Christ. The only reason why we do this is for the glory of Christ and share the truth, which not many people like. Even a lot of Christians, unfortunately, they attack us and they say, Rob, why are you so aggressive? Rob, why are you not humble, and why are you not political correct with Islam? But they don't know about Islam. Real Islam is not this baby-cute version here in the West. Real Islam is death, incest, sex, slavery, sex slaves. That's what real Islam is. The moment they become the number one power, they
will take your life. Ja, wenn die Leute nur wissen, was der wahre Islam ist, die würden Abneigung bekommen.
Ja, Amir, ne? Aber das Problem ist ja, die extrem Fanatischen, die finden das okay. Die finden das
gut. Ja, die extrem Fanatischen finden das okay. Die kannst du auch gar nicht mehr erreichen, weil die das einfach nur toll finden. Aber es gibt ja Millionen von Muslimen, die ein Riesenproblem mit sowas haben.
Ja, ja, das sind ja der Großteil der Muslime, 90% der Muslime.
Der Großteil der Muslime, genau.
Now guys, for the people who think that the Quran is from God, there are Muslims maybe who are listening or watching, they think still the one who wrote the Quran is Allah, right? Here is a challenge. If I, Rob Christian, can fix Allah's mistakes in the Arabic, does that mean I'm more powerful than Allah, Amir? If I can help Allah and fix his grammar mistakes in the Quran, does that mean I'm more powerful than Allah? The answer should be yes, right? Let me prove that Allah doesn't know Arabic. Let me prove that Allah doesn't know Arabic. Here is my
Allah point. Doesn't know Arabic.
Allah doesn't know Arabic. He should take his illiterate prophet and learn Arabic. Watch. Chapter 33, ayah 32 of the Quran, Surah Al-Ahzab. Who knows, guys? Allah made a grammar mistake. 33:32, grammar mistake. And let me prove that Muhammad, according to Allah, is gay. Muhammad, according to Allah, is gay. And should read the ayah like this. Husbands of the Prophet, you are not as other husbands. Why? Rob, how dare you to call a prophet liar? Or sorry, homosexual. Why? What are you trying to say, Rob? Well, here is why. Look, the Arabic reads like this. Ya Nisa al-Nabi, lastunna ka ahadin minan Nisa. Here Allah made a mistake. Why? Because in the Arabic language, you have masculine forms of words, and you have feminine, female or male forms of words. Any Semitic language, Orthodox, Aramaic, when we say something to a woman, you have to talk to her in grammar, good grammar, using female or feminine forms of words. Here Allah used for the woman, he called them men. It should not be
the Almighty Allah make a grammar mistake.
Yes. He calls them men ka'ahadin, here ka'ahadin. It should be ka'ihda, because these are women, not men. Did you catch it? So Allah made a grammar mistake. Now, since I can help Allah with his mistake, that means I am more powerful than Allah. Bada bam bam, bum bum.
Dingy, 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 dingy.
How can Allah, how can Muslims call Allah God, yet their God can make grammar mistakes? Calling Muhammad a homosexual in his Quran. So he makes the wives of Muhammad, the Nisa, he makes them women, men. So in other words, Muhammad, according to Allah in the Quran, he's a homosexual. He doesn't have wives, he has husbands. So the correct way to read it is, Ya Nisa al-Nabi, lastunna ka ihda, not ka ahadin. Allah says ka ahadin. No, it should be ka ihda, correct way. Allah made a mistake. There you go.
Rob, I have a question for you. Like, it's not a question, it's a statement from me. The Muslims always ask me, why are you so harsh with Islam? Like, wouldn't it be nicer and better for you to spread the Christianity with not criticizing the Islam? But I always tell them, your Quran tells that my dear Jesus Christ was not crucified, did not die for our sins, and he was not revived after that, you know? And I think that's the biggest disrespect that the Quran can bring to us Christians. That's the biggest disrespect.
Of course, brother, it's the Quran insults Jesus. The Quran insults his mother, Mary. The Quran calls literally, guys, for the people, who our brothers and sisters in Christianity, listen. In chapter 5, ayah 75, if you go to the tafsir, Surah Al-Ma'idah, chapter 5, ayah 75, Allah calls Jesus and Mary, he calls them animals. Animals. We should respect Allah and his religion. You should respect Muhammad and his religion, who insults our mother, the mother of our Lord, Mary, and our Lord Jesus Christ, calling them animals who are hungry.
Their Quran cannot respect other religions. Their Quran cannot respect other humans because of the beliefs from these humans, you know. And they always awaiting respect from us. Like, who are you guys that you cannot show us respect, but we show you respect, you know? Of course, I love my enemies. That's not the problem. I love my enemies. But
look, here is the proof, brother. Tafsir al-Baydawi for chapter 5. Ayah 75. It literally says, it's talking about Jesus and his mother, and they ate food like animals, like hungry animals that walk in the streets looking for food. This is what the Quran says about Jesus and his mother. We should respect the Quran and Islam, who insults our Lord and Savior and his mother.
I mean, Allah quotes us in Surah 8, verse like 55, the disbelievers are like animals.
Yeah, Jahil, the one who's saying is da'if hadith. It's not the hadith, it's a tafsir for the Quran. Don't confuse tafsir with hadith, ya Jahil. This is tafsir. Tafsir, ya Ahmar, Ibn Ahmar, tafsir.
Do easy.
Rob, please be patient.
I mean, they don't even know their books. He calls them haywanat, al-haywanat. Now let me show you what the fiqh says about women. Your mother, Mr. Hadith boy, da'if boy. Let's see what Islam teaches, what your mother is. Your mother, according to Islam, what she is. Watch. In Islam, guys, women are nothing but a walking, talking vagina. What? Yes, you heard it correctly. In Islam, women, your mothers, your sisters and daughters, according to Islam, they are nothing but talking, walking vaginas. And here's the proof. Here's my proof. Here is a book for fiqh. Fiqh, which is the end game of Islam. Ghidaat al-Albab, Ghidaat al-Bab, Sharh Manzumat al-Adhab, Volume 2. غداء الألباب شرح منظومات الأداب فقه book Islamic Jurisprudence Volume 2. Okay, this is the book. We open page 210. Here's the entire page. Look, scrolling up. The scholars al-ulama they agreed that the women, sorry, that the animals who can menstruate, animals, al-haywanat, that tahid, tahid min al-haywanat, are 8 type of animals. How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 8. Okay, 8. And they start with the woman, and then the hyena, and the bat, the rabbit, the female dog, the female horse. So in other words, this is what the scholars said about women in Islam. 8 type of animals who can menstruate, who can bleed. Among them is a woman. They start with a woman. Al-mar'a. Here. Haywana. Your mother is a haywana, according to your scholars.
So they are walking, talking farjahas?
Yeah. Walking, talking virginias. Virginia, brother. Literally, women in Islam are not human beings. Now, do you understand why Muhammad called women half-brained? They have the
half-brain. Yeah, they have the deficiency in her mind.
Yeah, this is the level of, for women in Islam. Do you see it? Now let's see what Allah called women. Let me prove what Allah called women in the Quran. I hope the Muslims won't fade now. They won't leave Islam, because you know, if you leave Islam, Allah won't give you 72 hur al-ayn. Don't leave Islam, brother. Even if you Allah insults your own mother. Okay? Don't leave Islam, please. Look, here is the ayah of the Quran, Surah Al-Waqi'ah, chapter 56, ayah 37. And I challenge any sheikh to come and say, Rob, you're lying. Yalla, come. Debate me about it. Surah Al-Waqi'ah, chapter 56, ayah 37. عُرُوبًا أَطْرَابًا عُرُوبًا. This word here, what we're looking for. Let's see what the scholars said about it. Let's see what the scholars said about it. Here is a book. Tafsir by Al-Jalalain. شقاق الأطرج في رقاق الهنش by جلال الدين عبد الرحمن بن أبي بكر السيوطي. Short for جلال الدين السيوطي. The same guy who wrote Tafsir al-Jalalain. You know him, right, guys?
Yes, yes, al-Jalalain. Yeah,
he
we know him.
He wrote many books. He wrote many Tafsir books. And this book is specifically about erotic book. Erotic. It's about sex. Specifically, yeah, he wrote a book about sex. I'm not kidding. It's called Shaqaq al-Atraj fi Raqaq al-Ghunj. And he showed basically all the ayahs of the Quran. And he explaining the ayah about in the Quran for sex. Because Quran is sex book. Jalal al-Din al-Suyuti.
Quran is
sex. Yes, Quran is
sex. Ich weiß nicht, wo du den her hast, aber ich liebe diesen Rob Christian. Seitdem der hier war, ich schaue den immer wieder.
Ja, der kennt sich sehr gut aus. Also. Der kennt sich ultra gut aus.
Ja, und weißt du, was der Mami dann sagt? Der Rob Christian, ein Lügner, der ist daiv, der ist so. Und sofort
ja, bringen wir den Leben. Soll er sagen, Rob Christian hat recht, dann vernichtet er die gesamte Religion. Also muss er das sagen.
Look, guys. قال الله. So here Allah is going to explain the ayah that we showed you in chapter 56, ayah 37. قال الله. Allah himself said. قال الله تعالى. Allah said. في صفات نساء أهل الجنة. For the description of the women who will go to Jannah. Let's say your beloved mother, ya Sunni Muslim. She will die. She will go to Jannah. Or maybe you have a baby daughter or sister. Let's see what Allah calls them. إِنَّا إِنْشَأْنَهُنَّ إِنْشَاءً. This Quran, فَجَعَلْنَاهُنَّ أَبْكَارًا عُرُوبًا أَطْرَابًا. You see this word? عُرُوبًا أَطْرَابًا. Chapter 56, ayah 37. Look what it says here. أَطْبَقُ الْمُفَسِّرُونَ. The scholars who give commentary like جلال الدين السيوطي, all of them, brother. الْمُفَسِّرُونَ. All the tafsir that is. أَطْبَقُ الْمُفَسِّرُونَ. وَأَهْلِ اللُّغَةِ, meaning the scholars of the Arabic language. عَلَى. إن العرب, the word عرب, جمع عربة, it's the plural form, أو عرب, عرب, وإنها القحبة. This is what your mother is according to Allah, brothers and sisters.
Your so betitelt Allah die Frauen als قحبس.
So in the ayah, عربة, this word here, hear my finger? means prostitute. This is what Allah calls your mother and sister and daughter. So, brothers and sisters, this is not me. This is your Islam. This is what your mother is. Qahba, she's the woman of the streets.
Absoluter Wahnsinn.
Das ist eine Vollkatastrophe, ist das.
Do you see it? Now, some people say, Rob, you created this. They will say, Rob, you created this.
Rob, you make some hadith. You fabricate hadith. Look. You have the authority and the power to create hadith. To put hadith in the books.
Yeah. Look, guys, this is the book. I downloaded it. You can download this book literally from the internet. Shaqaq al-Atraj fi Raqaq al-Ghunj. PDF. Do you see it, brothers and sisters? PDF. From noorbook.com. I downloaded it for free. It has 210 pages. Look, here's the book. And here is PDF. Don't say, Rob, you're lying. This is the cover of the book. Shaqaq al-Atraj fi Raqaq al-Ghunj. Ta'lif. Imam al-Hafiz Jalaluddin al-Suyuti. He died in the year 911 Hijrah, after Hijrah, wow. The Islamic year. Right? And even he gave the one who is basically giving, he compiled it, this work. We go to page 69. Look, I'm scrolling. You don't say, Rob, you created this. Scrolling all the way to page 69. I like the number, by the way, 69. 69. Okay? Here. You see? 69. Here on top, قال الله تعالى في
السلام عليكم من بودا.
إن إنشأنهن إنشأن وفجعلنهن أبكارا عربا أطرابا. What is it? وإنها القحبة. I only took a screenshot. Let me make it a little bit bigger. You see, if I increase the percentage, the page will become bigger. Look. Here. Here's my cursor. You see it? This is what Uruban here, the word Uruban, this is what it means. وَإِنَّا الْقَحْبَ. So don't say, Rob, you're lying. I only took a screenshot and I put some commentary here for the people who don't know Arabic.
Rob, you're a liar.
You are not like Sheikh Uthman who creates his own hadith.
No, exactly.
But Rob, I have a question. So basically, An-Nasa'i told that Al-Waqidi is a liar, but An-Nasa'i said it is permitted to give the milk with the breast, or what?
Well, Ibn Hajar made the hadith famous, brother. Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, he made the hadith famous. But he didn't tell the people that he used the hadith of Al-Waqidi. He lied about it. Like, pick any scholar, brother. Sometimes Muslims, they give a lot of respect to the classical scholars like Ibn Kathir, Ibn Hajar. But also the old scholars are liars. Don't forget it.
Yes.
All of them are liars. Don't
ja, sobald es problematisch wird, sobald es problematisch wird, wird auch ein Ibn Kathir auf einmal, ne? Er kann auch auf einmal Fehler machen. Merkt ihr? So unehrlich ist das Ganze.
Ibn Kathir said the satanic verses are a lie, right, guys? Ibn Kathir, he said that the satanic verses are a lie. What if I can prove to you that the satanic verses is sahih? Write me right now. Shall we prove it? The satanic verses incident, you know, when they tried to analyze the gentleman, the famous guy in the United Kingdom, Salman Rushdie, he wrote in the 80s a book called Satanic Verses. Right? They tried to kill him, by the way, huh?
Like they always do.
Yeah. So let me prove that the satanic verses is authentic as it can be. Authentic.
Yes.
And I will show you also Sahih al-Bukhari as well. No problem.
Kann ich Hallo sagen? Ich grüße euch, Brüder. I hope you are all doing fine. Rob, I hope you are doing fine as well.
Thank you. Appreciate it. We are having fun a little bit today. You know, Amir here is driving his Mercedes.
big Mercedes. From the biggest companies here.
Remember that Sheikh who was challenging a brother, Christian Prince, he said, I challenge you for a BMW Model 5. Remember that? I'll give you a BMW 5 if you debate me. The guy died a week later, he died.
No.
Yeah, that sheikh. You remember that old sheikh from Indonesia? Model 5 BMW. Remember him?
No. No.
No, forget about it. Anyway, it's these people, bro. It's funny. Look, Ad-Durr al-Manthur for the satanic verses. Ad-Durr al-Manthur again, Jalalain.
Ah, this is from Jalalain.
Jalalain, yes. Same guy.
Ah, this is Dr. Sheikh Abu Amir. Kennt die ganzen Bücher des Sunnis?
Look, Ad-Durr al-Manthur. Jalal al-Din al-Suyuti, volume 10. Jalal al-Din al-Suyuti. I love al-Suyuti. He always barbecues Islam.
Yeah.
He yes. loves to barbecue Islam.
Imam al-Suyuti, Imam al-Suyuti barbecue Islam for
thousands of
times.
Page, let us go
I
to
love
page
him.
525 and 526. Look.
I like this guy.
526. 526. Surah al-Hajj. This is the important ayah, right? Surah al-Hajj. Ayahs 52 to 55. Tafsir. Tafsir. Look. Sahih. Satanic verses. Satanic verses is sahih. Look, read it.
Aha! Yeah, elenden Lügner here.
Always lying. They say satanic verses is created by the enemies of Muhammad.
Kleinen Lügner, Kazaben.
Kazaben.
Never trust a Muslim.
Never, ever. Uthman ibn Farooq said it's fabricated, right?
Yeah, because he's embarrassed.
Yeah. Look,
he fabricated his own hadith.
Now, guys, here's the satanic verses. Al Muhammad Rasulullah, he was reading in Mecca. This happened in Mecca, right? Surah An-Najm, chapter 53. Falamma balagha, when he reached this part in the Quran, chapter 53, ayahs 19 and 20. 19 and 20. أَفْرَأَيْتُمَ اللَّاتَ وَالْعُزَّةَ وَمَنَاتَ الثَّالِثَةَ الْأُخْرَى. Have you seen اللات العزة ومنات the third and last? Surah An-Najm 53, chapter 53, ayahs 19 and 20. ألقى Satan cast الشيطان. ألقى الشيطان على لسانه. Satan cast down on the tongue of Muhammad, lisan, shaitan ala lisani, tilka al-gharaniq al-ula. The satanic verses is this. Look, guys, this part, let me show you. This part is the satanic verses. Two verses. This is why it's called satanic verses, two of them. Tilka al-gharaniq al-ula wa inna shafa'atahunna la turtaja. These are the exalted gharaniq. The bird idols, Alat al-Uzza wal-Manat. Why bird idols? Because they used to carry the prayer of the Meccans, the pagans of Mecca, all the way to Allah, who existed before Islam, to give him the prayers of the Quraysh so that Allah can listen. So they were intercessors, right? Tilkil gharaniq al-ula wa inna shafa'atahunna la turtaja. And their intercession is hoped for. Aywa. When the Quraysh, the Meccans heard it, they said, we never heard this beautiful stuff about our idols before. Until today, قبل اليوم.
Thank you.
Then look what did Muhammad do. فَسَجَدَ سُجُود. Muhammad prostrates.
Muhammad hat sich schön niedergebeugt vor den Al-Uzza, Al-Manat und Al-Lat.
Translate to them, Muhammad became a mushrik today. Mushrik.
Ja, Muhammad hat die unvergegbare Sünde im Islam begangen. Er hat Schirk begangen. Er hat neben Allah andere Götter angebetet.
Sujud is an act of worship.
Bruder, hier passiert gerade etwas sehr, sehr Lustiges. Guck mal, ich sag's erstmal auf Deutsch. Normalerweise heulen sie immer rum, dass wir kein Arabisch können. Und jetzt heulen sie rum, dass wir Arabisch können. Cool, for Rob Christian, usually the Arab guys are complaining about we are not Arab speakers, you know? And now you are talking about them and citing them. And now are they complaining about you can speak Arabic, you know?
You see how sahih it is, guys? Satanic verses.
Not normal.
Sahih. I did videos about this on YouTube, guys. Sahih. So it is, but people can only lie. Now let me show you more lies in Sahih al-Bukhari. How they lie, how they literally lie to people, guys. How they lie to people in Sahih al-Bukhari. Let's say, Amir, you know, you buy the complete volume for Sahih al-Bukhari, right? You know, it's always multi-volume, right? Right, guys?
Yeah.
What I'm trying to say is this. What I'm trying to say is this, the following, guys. When you buy the Arabic books, they won't translate it. Look, here is example, Sahih al-Bukhari. Volume 6. This is translation, as you see. Translation, volume 6. Sahih al-Bukhari, Arabic English. Dar es Salaam, this is, by the way, Saudi Arabia. Do you see it? Saudi Arabia. Yeah. The liars and deceivers in Saudi Arabia. Now, let me show you why they are liars. Sahih al-Bukhari, volume 6, Imam al-Bukhari. Okay. We go to page 210, translation. Kitab al-Tafsir, chapter number 65. Kitab al-Tafsir, the book of Tafsir. Yes, also in Sahih al-Bukhari, you have commentary book. Chapter 65, page 210. Here's the entire page. Now, what do you notice here, Amir? What do you see here? If you look at this page, what do you see? What is missing here? What is wrong?
There is no commentary.
No translation here.
No translation.
I'm empty.
Please, Rob. Can
what they,
do
what they talking? What they talking in this hadith?
Yeah.
What they're talking about?
They did not dare to translate it. So imagine you buy this entire volume for $1,000. Because very expensive books, Amir, very expensive.
Yeah, I know.
They don't translate. Look, it's blanco.
I wonder why.
Translated the, look, Surah Al-Hajj, and then stop. No translation. Why? Ask yourself why. Because the satanic verses is here in Sahih al-Bukhari.
Ach du Heilige, guckt euch das bitte an. Sie haben es nicht übersetzt, weil die satanischen Verse sogar in Sahih al-Bukhari sind. Unfassbar.
Even if you go to sunnah.com, brother, you go to sunnah.com, the online version of Sahih al-Bukhari, they didn't translate it. They don't dare to translate embarrassing stuff about their prophet. This is why anybody should leave Islam immediately.
Jeder sollte den Islam verlassen.
Why, guys? Now let's see why this is damaging. Why they did not dare to translate it. Watch. I put my translation, I will show you, because I am more honest than the Muslim scholars. Look, this is Ibn Abbas in Sahih al-Bukhari. Guys, this is Sahih al-Bukhari. Okay? It says here, وقال ابن عباس, explaining chapter 22, ayah 52, the satanic verses, ayah. It says here that when Satan cast down on the tongue of Muhammad, ويقول ابن عباس said, أمنيته قراءته, meaning, Ibn Abbas explains that the أمنيته is قراءته, his reading. So the reading of Muhammad, Satan put Quran of his own in it. This is the Quran of Satan putting on the tongue of Muhammad. They didn't translate it because Ibn Abbas talking, explaining what it means.
So eine unehrliche Glaubensgemeinschaft habe ich in meinem Leben nicht gesehen.
So I am giving my own translation. Here it's missing. Do you see it? I have to do it. Do you see how they deceive people, guys?
Look,
Ibn Abbas says, like the ayah, right? Whenever you see these beautiful symbols here, the brackets, is Quran. إذا تمنى ألقى الشيطان في أمنيته إذا الله ما يلقي الشيطان ويحكم آياته. Meaning, Ibn Abbas explains, ويقول أمنيته, the desire is the قراءة. The narration of Shaitan. So literally the words of Shaitan became Quran.
Yes.
Crazy. Rob, you are such a favor. We need guys like you in our Christian Ummah.
Look, guys, again, we go translation. No translation. Let's see if that's I can crazy. Find the online version on sunnah.com to show you, to prove to you. Also on sunnah.com, they did not translate it. They did not dare to translate it. Let's see. We go to sunnah.com. Sunnah.com. We go to Sahih al-Bukhari, book number.
And they change also the meaning of the words.
Yes, they change everything, brother. Everything is changed.
Yeah. You cannot trust every one of them.
Yes. Book. Let's see. Book of Tafsir, as we said. 65. Look. Here is sunnah.com. All of us use it, right? When we need information. Sunnah.com. Look on top. Sunnah.com. Okay? Here is the chapter. Prophetic commentary, the book of Tafsir, Kitab al-Tafsir, sunnah.com. We go to the correct hadith. We go to the correct part, whereas this is. Let's see, I have to. Okay. Just give me a second, guys. Wait, let us go to the correct part because we don't want to make mistakes like the Muslims. We don't want to make mistake like the Muslims because we are Christians. We are not allowed to lie. Right, guys?
I mean, we are not allowed to lie.
We are not allowed to lie like the Muslims.
Brother Rob, you have to hurry up. I have to go now. Five minutes. I give you 5 minutes.
All right, Habibi, 5 minutes. Because my battery is dying as well, so it's maybe time to close. Look, guys.
Allah is disturbing you.
Yeah.
Technical jihad.
Here, I found it. I literally found it. Okay, here. Look, guys, if we go to the correct book, look, and right on top, Sahih al-Bukhari 47-41, right? The book number is 65. So if you write down sunnah.com/Bukhari/65, sunnah.com, here, right on top of this hadith, 47-41, right on top of it, you find the saying that they did not translate. Look, this part, they didn't translate it. Look. Surat al-Hajj, no translation. Even the online version, no translation. No translation, guys. Why?
Only in Arabic, so only Muslims can read this. Only in Arabic, so only Muslims will read this. Yeah.
Well, here is Ibn Abbas.
I'm recording right now.
What is the hadith? Hadith number?
Right on top of hadith number 47. 47, 41. Right on top of
it. Ich nehme alles auf, Amir, ich schick's dir.
Yeah.
Right on top of it. They didn't translate this part. Why? Rob, and specifically here. وَيَقُولُ أُمْنِيَتَهُ وَقِرَاءَتَهُ. The qira of shaitan himself, a shaitan. Yeah, go ahead, brother.
Translate. I recorded it and then I will send it to you.
Yeah, this part is about shaitan, right? About the chapter 22, ayah 52, right? And Ibn Abbas explained what the umniya is, the desire. Wayaqul, Ibn Abbas explains, the desire is the qira'ah of shaitan. Boom!
Like Rob Christian, he's a Muslim guy who's always in our streams. He's saying the translations are not completed yet, but you showed us Sahih al-Bukhari, where it was a book for $1,000 and it was not yet finished translation or what?
You know the website called Internet Archive. You can download basically all the books for free.
Yeah, I know the site. Look, they have also stuff. Yeah.
Sahih al-Bukhari, volume 6, 4474, all the way to hadith number 5062. Here is the page. I always take screenshots, guys, because the books are huge. Look, here's the page in front of you. Here is page 220, 220 and 221. Look, here this part is missing, like I said.
Maybe this is a Musaf.
Missing.
It was not completed yet. It will be added later.
It's not complete.
They had 1,000 years time, you know?
Literally, PDF. Archive. Archive.org. Volume 6. You can literally download this, guys. Literally, look. You right-click and save as image. That's what I did. Christians are not liars. Muslims can lie for their religion. The scholars will lie to protect Islam. That's what they've been always doing.
And they are teaching this.
Yes. I mean, come on, man. What is this cult, bro? Why is Islam always needs to lie? Because it's from Satan. Because it's a satanic religion, they need to deceive people. That's why. Jesus, on the other hand, is the truth. Jesus told us to read the books, to investigate the books. That's what Jesus says in the Bible. In Islam, chapter 5 in the Quran, chapter 5 says, don't ask questions.
It's the proof what you are saying there.
Yes. Don't ask questions.
Don't ask too many questions, huh? Allah hates when you ask too many questions.
We always say if you are a Muslim and you have like enough knowledge about the Islam, you will leave the Islam immediately.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Rob, there was a tafsir to that verse who says, don't ask too many questions because there are many men of religion who ask questions and then they lose their faith because of them.
You know why? Ibn Taymiyyah, Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, brothers and sisters, he was very, very clear about it. If you ask questions, this is what will happen. Watch. Let me put it on the screen for everybody. If you ask questions, that's what you are called. Look. Shaykh al-Islam, the teacher of Ibn Kathir, said this. In Kitab al-Ibana min Usul al-Diyana, volume 18, page 18. That's why Ibn Taymiyyah said, read with me, he who uses philosophy uses logic, and he who uses logic has become a heretic. No!
Sobald Muslime logisch denken und über den Koran nachdenken, wird es zur Heresie, versteht ihr? Dann kommen sie nämlich auf die Schliche, ne? Das ist das.
Yes, and here is the proof from in the Arabic, because the Muslims say, Rob, you create this. Rob, you create this. No, I created the translation. you're lying, Rob.
you are kazab, Rob. You're kazab, Rob.
Yeah. Oh, man. Maktaba is not working. Why today it's not working?
Maktaba.
Oh, no, it's working. Okay, look, here's the book. Maktabat al-Shamila. This is, by the way, that Uthman ibn Farooq uses. It. Remember when he said Maktabat al-Shamila? This is the one. The library, Shamila. He uses this. Sharh Kitab Ibana min Usul al-Diyana. Right? We go down. Volume 18, page 18. Look, and here's the saying of Ibn Taymiyyah. Qal ibn Taymiyyah. Man tafalsaf. The one who uses philosophy, فَقَدْ تَمَنْطَقْ. He has used logic. So if you use philosophy, you use logic. Ibn Taymiyyah said, وَمَنْ تَمَنْطَقْ. And the one who uses logic, فَقَدْ تَزَنْدَقْ. Zindiq. You know what the meaning of zindiq?
Zindiq, yeah, ketzer. You're out of ketzer. Zindiq bedeutet ketzer.
You see, we don't lie. We don't need to lie like Muslims.
Let me screenshot it, bro. Thanks. Yeah.
Here is Ibn Taymiyyah, by the way.
Rob, is it okay for you that we maybe continue the stream after Amir closes it? Because some people are asking in the comment section.
Continue where, brother?
Maybe on my channel, maybe on Sheikh Yabuti's channel or on yours.
Sure, brother. I don't do live streams anymore on TikTok because I always use my accounts. Muslims flag me. I had to create literally 8 or 9 accounts. I lost my main account.
Ja, die haben ihn schon voll aufgesperrt, ne? Das ist heftig.
So I better use other people's live streams, you know.
Yeah, it's maybe you can then join.
So invite me, sure. Let me add you. Who's the one talking? Sorry.
Adlerblick.
Ist Abu Bush online?
You can add my account, Adlerblick.
Okay.
Add mine too.
Sheikh Yabuti, okay.
You know my words? I have translated your works in German language.
beautiful. I added both of you guys, so if you need me or whatever, send me a message and sure.
That's cool. That's really good. That's a really good.
Ja, das ist doch super. Ne? Kann ja auch aushelfen, der Rob. Ne? Da ist er da.
Ja, Amir, ich sag dir, das, was du angefangen hast, ne, vor ein paar Jahren, mit dem Fell rein.
Das, was ich hab den ganzen Stein zum Laufen gebracht, ne? Den ganzen Stein zum Rollen gebracht.
Das ist nicht gelogen. Also in Deutschland war es nicht cool, so etwas zu tun. Also der Stürzenberger hat das schon Jahre vorher gemacht, aber keiner hat ihm zugehört. Keine Jugendkultur oder so. Du hast wirklich so einen Hype darum gemacht, dass die ganzen Jugendlichen sich mal wirklich mit ihrer Religion auseinandersetzen, ne?
Yeah. Guys, we have a Muslim in the chat. He says, Rob, you're lying. Ibn Taymiyyah talking about Ahlul Kalam. Why are you lying? Okay, what are Ahlul Kalam? The people of philosophy. So in other words, don't use philosophy in Islam. Don't use logic in Islam. Don't think about Allah. Who is Allah? Why Allah sits on his chair? Why Allah has five hands? Two hands? Why Allah has five fingers?
Yeah.
Why Allah has a foot in Jahannam, in hellfire? Don't ask questions, yeah. Brother. Right?
Just accept it.
Brother.
Rob, we just follow accept. Muhammad blindly. Eh? Do you know the sentence of this sheikh? We follow Muhammad blindly and too deep thinking.
Yeah, don't think about the fact. Yeah, no. Don't use your brains, brothers and sisters, because you cannot think why Allah looks like this. Look, this is Allah. Challenge me about it. This is Allah. He has two right hands. He has curly hair. He's a young man and he's wearing a green suit. This is your Allah. Challenge me for the debate. Yalla. Challenge me if this is not Allah. I will prove it.
Okay, Leute. Now I quit the live stream. And we see us maybe later, God willing. And God bless you, everybody here.
It was Leute, a very nice day.
Gott segne euch, ihr Lieben. Ich mache jetzt mal Pause und dann komme ich eventuell später wieder live. Ne?
Habibi,
thank you for your patience. Thank you for your knowledge that you're sharing with us. God bless you and take care of you.
To the German friends in the chat, ich liebe dich, Bruder.
Ich liebe dich, Bruder.
God bless you and your family, brother.
You're good.
Habibi, God bless you.
God bless you.
Okay, God bless you. Gott segne euch, ihr Lieben. Dann macht's gut, ja? Ciao, bis später. Gott segne euch.
Ciao, mir Bruder. Heute macht's gut.
Gott segne euch, ciao.
God bless you, Habibi. Bye bye.